Hello my dear students, how are you all? I hope you will fine and I welcome you to the science class for class 8. And today we are going to learn the remaining thing of chapter 8, that is cell structure and function. So without wasting time, let's get started. But before proceeding today's class, let's quickly revise what we have learned so far. So we have learned that all the plants, all the animals and all the microorganisms are made up of cell. Okay, yes. Cell, okay, yes. These cells are very small and we cannot see them with our naked eyes, okay. So we can see them with the help of hand lens or with the help of microscope, okay, yes. Then we learned that the famous scientist named Robert Hooke discovered first time cell, okay. Where he discovered the cell in the bark of tree, okay, that is called cork, c-o-r-k, okay, yes. So first of all he discovered, then afterwards it was advanced, okay, yes. Then we saw the cell, so we studied that the cell is the basic structural unit. Structural unit, okay. Just like how our wall is made up of, our home is made up of wall and our wall is made up of brick, okay, yes. So many brick joined together to form wall, and by joining wall it form a home, okay. Similarly, cell are joined together, okay, to form a organ. And organ are joined together to form organ system, and again the whole body of a living thing, okay, yes. Then we saw the cell number. We saw depending upon the number of cell, the organisms can be defined, can be categorized as unicellular and multicellular. So those organisms which are made up of single cell are called unicellular. So examples of unicellular are amoeba, paramecium and euglena. And multicellular, those organs which are made up of millions and billions of cells, those are called multicellular, like all the insects, all the human being, and all the plant body, okay, yes. Then we saw the cell size. We saw that cell size can differ from 0.1 micron to 170 mm, okay. So the ostrich egg is the biggest cell and the bacterium cell is the smallest cell. Then we saw cell shape. So in cell shape we have a different shapes of cell, okay, just like a god cell, which is a kidney shape, okay, like a branch cell which is found in our nerve cell, okay, red blood cell which are round and biconcave, then amoeboid shape, the examples are WBC, okay, then spiral shape, then spherical shape, then rod shape, okay. So cells cell have a different shape, okay, yes. Then we saw the cell function and cell structure and function. So we saw that the cell is a basic structural unit, like cell are joined together to form tissue, okay, then a tissue are joined together, or many tissue form together to form organ, then many organs joined together to form organ system, and then organ system, many organ system and other thing are joined together to form a human body or animal body, okay, yes. So these are the different organs in our body, okay. Yes, similarly in plants we have a different organ like flower, fruit, seed, leaf, stem and root, okay, yes. Then we saw plant cell and animal cell, and we saw the differences, okay, yes. So here is the detailed difference, okay, yes. So if we compare plant cell and animal cell, so we find that the there are something which are present only in plant cell, okay, and there are something which is present in both. So just like cell wall, the cell wall is present only in plant cell, okay. The large vacuole, this is the large vacuole, okay, so this is present in the plant cell. The chloroplast, which is responsible for the green color of plant, okay, so that thing, okay, that thing is also present in only plant cell, okay, yes. And the cell wall is not present in animal cell, large vacuole is not present in animal cell, there is no chloroplast present in animal cell, okay, yes. Flagella only in gametes, okay, then here is also flagella, okay, yes. Then what is common in both? We have a mitochondrion, okay, mitochondrion. Then this mitochondrion is present in both, okay, yes, you can see here. Okay, yes, here. Then Golgi apparatus, okay, yes. Then rough and smooth endospermic reticulum, okay, yes, here. Here is endospermic reticulum and here is Golgi complex, okay, yes. Here here you have a endosplasmic reticulum and Golgi apparatus you can find here, okay, yes. Then cytoplasm is present in both, here also cytoplasm is present and here also cytoplasm is present. Then ribosomes, this also present in both, okay, yes. So this is the comparison between a plant cell and animal cell. Then we have organelles. So organelles are the different component in a cell, okay. So if this is a cell wall and here is a cytoplasm, the liquid filled, okay. So whatever the organs are present, like nucleus, ribosomes, DNA, RNA, okay, and everything is, whatever is present inside, that is the organelles, okay, yes. So we have a different organelles and their function, okay. Like nucleus, what is the function of nucleus? So it contain and protect genetic material, okay, genetic material, okay, yes. So just like if a mango plant is there and its taste is very sweet, so if its seed will, if a new plant will grow from its seed, so that will also have a sweet taste, okay, yes. So that is the genetic material. Then we have our DNA or chromosome. So chromosome is the information for making protein, okay, yes. Then ribosome is used for makes protein, okay, yes. Then we saw endosplasmic reticulum, what it does, it transport and finish protein. Then we have a lysosome, so it break down the protein. Then we have a mitochondria, so it's help in the cellular respiration. Then we have a Golgi apparatus, it modifies, store and routes cell products, okay, yes. Then we have a cytoplasm. So cytoplasm is a space work to be done, okay. So cytoplasm is a space, whatever space is between nucleus and the cell wall, okay, cell membrane is present, that is the filled with the cytoplasm, okay, yes. Then we have a vesicles, then we have that is for cellular packaging, okay. Then vacuoles is for digestion and storage. Then we have a cell membrane that is used to regulate chemicals, okay, yes, and it define the shape of the cell, okay, yes. The next is a prokaryote and eukaryote, okay. So what you mean by prokaryote? So it simply means the cell in which, okay, the cell in which nucleus is absent, okay, nuclear membrane is absent, okay. Suppose here is this is a nucleus, okay, but there is no defined membrane, okay, but here this is the eukaryote, here you have a defined nucleus membrane, okay. So the cell in which there is a defined nucleus membrane, those are called eukaryotic. And where nucleus membrane is not proper, not properly organized, not properly present, those are called prokaryotic. Okay, yes. So difference is that. So in prokaryotic, that means in this, you have a nucleoid, but in eukaryotic, you have a nucleus. So just like this, you have a nucleus, here you have a nucleoid. Okay, yes. Then here you have a circular DNA, you can see here circular DNA. Okay, and you have a linear DNA, just like this. Okay, yes. And in both you have a cell, cell membrane and ribosome. Okay, yes. This is the difference between prokaryotic and eukaryotic. Okay, so that's all. Here you finish your this chapter. Okay, yes. So here you have some question, try to attempt it, that is differentiate between plants and animal cell. And what are prokaryotic and eukaryotic? You just explain it. Okay, yes, in few words. Thank you so much. Keep studying. Bye bye.